highly creative food. The recipes Charles Palmer brings us today, starting with pan-seared venison steaks, are fine examples of this talented young chef's repertoire.
Venison has become much more popular these days in the last few years because of its health benefits. It's very lean. It's a very lean meat. It's very nutritious. And with farm-raised animals like this, much milder than what we're used to in the past. In European markets, it's always been much more acceptable, you know, as far as gaminess and, you know, the intensity of venison. In America, I think people like it much better if it's not so gamey and it's nice and fresh. We're also not going to use a marinade or anything on this dish. It's simply fresh venison. We're going to take the coarse pepper and put a good amount on there. Again, you want to get like a crust on this. And also take the coarse salt. I'm going to turn them over. Same thing on the other side. You want to season up pretty high so you get a good even distribution. Now, this is a professional meat pounder. You could use the back of a pan, or you could use basically anything that's flat and slightly heavy. We're going to pound these down. We're not going to pound it flat. We just want to like flatten it out and embed the pepper into meat. See how it's kind of like nice flat surface there. Now once they're pounded, they should be about 3/4 inch thick. All right. We'll get that done. We'll move them over here. For the sauce today, we're going to use some sun-dried sour cherry that we've got plumped up here in the water. Just a little hot water over top. Just take and drain those. Don't worry about a little juice. You're going to go into the sauce. You're going to reduce it anyways. Okay. Now we're going to take our shallots and mince them. This sauce is really just a simple reduction. Flavors in it come from the meat when we saute it in a pan, as I'll show you in a minute. And then also the Pinot Noir, which is nice and fruity, is going to add a lot of flavor to the sauce. And then you get also the obvious flavor from the cherries that comes out. Again, a nice fruity thing. And then we get a little lime parsley here. Washed up nicely and picked. You don't want any stems or anything left in it. I'm going to mince that up. And we don't want this parsley too fine, so we're just going to kind of chop it. I want to see it in the sauce once we're finished. That's good like that. There you go. Okay, now we're going to take the venison and we're going to saute. Okay, now to saute this, what we're actually trying to do is sear the meat. So we got to make sure the pan is very hot. And we're going to use about a tablespoon of, this is grapeseed oil. You could use corn oil. Now you see when it goes in the pan, you can see that the pan is quite hot. I'm going to just use enough oil to film the pan. And when you place the venison into the pan, make sure you let it splash away from you. Any fat will go that way, as opposed to on your hand. Now when you say, you don't want a crowded pan. Now if you're going to do this for sick people, you might want to use two pans, you know, to make sure there's plenty of space. You want to get some room. And what we're trying to do is like form a crust on the bottom of the meat. So, once you sear in the juices, and the reason we're going to keep these about an inch thick or 3/4 inch thick is to make sure the inside stays nice and rare. We need about 2 to 3 minutes on each side. So once it crusts up, we'll flip them over. Nice hot fire. Now once you've seared the side for about 2 to 3 minutes, we're going to just take and turn it over. Now see, you've got a nice crust there. The pepper's embedded to the meat itself, you know, and you get a nice brown layer. We're going to do the same thing on the other side. Now, the important thing is to keep the venison nice and rare. 2 minutes on a side. I'm going to show you a little way to test it. You take your hand and gently squeeze there and press on your thumb. No, we're trying to keep these rare, so it should be just a little bit softer than what you feel there. So now in the pan, you're going to do the same thing. Now, get about another 30 seconds to a minute here. And we'll keep them nice and rare, because then we're going to take them out of the pan, put them into the sauce once it's finished, and kind of baste them just a second before we plate it. Okay, we got them about rare. Now we're going to take them out of the pan. I'm going to heat down a little bit here. Set them on the side. I'm going to let the pan just cool for a second. We're going to drain most of the fat off of the pan. And we're going to take our shallots. Now, the pan is somewhat dry, but the shallots are just going to pick up any fat in the pan and bring up the caramelization in the bottom here. You're not really trying to brown the shallots too much. You're just going to bring up any juices left there. What I was saying before, a little Pinot Noir. We're going to use about 3/4 of a cup. Deglaze the pan. Now this is the flavor. If you go a little bit too much, as far as the wine is concerned, it doesn't matter. You're just going to reduce down the wine, you know. Actually, the more wine, the better the flavor. You don't want to go too crazy, but it's essentially a nice fruity wine, you know, like a lot of flavor, again, with the cherries. I'm going to take the chicken stock. Just let this reduce for 1 second. Now you can reduce the stock together. Nice flavorful chicken stock. This is not a heavy sauce, but it will congeal because of the chicken stock. And once we finish it with the butter, we'll get all the juices up from the bottom of the pan. Now that's the flavor that's going to go into the sauce too. From the venison. When we put the venison back in, you're going to have the pepper flavor. We got the plum cherries going in here, and the parsley. Now we're just going to take and reduce this down by about half. This dish is nice too, because you're not burning a lot of pans. Keep the same pan. Once you've got it reduced by about half, you're going to add the butter. I'm just going to kind of monte it in there. Just want to basically melt the butter into it, which is a thickener and also has a nice mellow. Mellows out the sauce a little bit. We're going to check it for flavor. I think we're going to need a little touch of salt in there. And then we're going to put the mignons back in the sauce and kind of baste them for a minute. Juices you got on that plate now. Put it right back into the sauce. Just kind of baste over the top. At this point, we got a great aroma. Got nice colors in there too, with the Italian parsley, the cherries on top. Now, once the mignons are heated up nicely, we're going to go and plate the dish. We're going to serve this today with a little butternut squash flan, kind of a play on a traditional vegetable, autumn vegetable. Just run the knife around there, loosen it up, and invert it on the plate, and some really crisp Paul Maxime, the herbs sandwiched in between. And we're going to just take a little bit of that sauce and drizzle it around the outside and over top. And chervil sprig on top there. Nice and clean.
Charlie Palmer grew up in a family of farmers and hunters, so his expertise with wild game came easily. His farm-raised venison looks and tastes a lot like beef, and you can use the same recipe for beef tenderloin or lamb loin steaks. As for the potato maximes, here's how you make them. Charlie uses a mandolin like this, but you can use any kind of a slicer, but the important thing is you've got to get paper-thin slices of potato. First, preheat your oven to 350 degrees. Then brush the baking sheet with clarified butter and set it aside. Next, prepare the potatoes for slicing by peeling them, shaping them into neat ovals. Then slice them just as thin as possible. Now, working quickly so the potatoes won't discolor, lay the slices next to each other on the baking sheet. Lay a sprig of fresh herb on each slice. Then cover the slice with a matching slice of potato. Press each one down firmly to seal the two slices together. Then brush the tops with clarified butter. Season lightly with salt. And then bake them in your preheated 350 oven until it's about 10 minutes until they're a beautiful golden brown. You let them drain on paper towels and you serve them at room temperature, and they keep very nicely for several hours. You might make a few extra just to have something to munch on while you're waiting for your guests. Chef Charlie is known for his spectacular desserts, and this next recipe, a meltingly warm chocolate mousse cupcake with a hint of tarragon, it's typical Palmer, handsome and unusual to look